Welcome to the Zeropark onboarding tutorial. I will show you how to create a campaign in Zeropark. You will learn about the types of traffic and campaigns at your disposal so you can get your ads online and start making a profit. First, to create a new campaign, you should log into your account. Go to the dashboard and click on the New Campaign tab. Select the traffic type. There are three types of traffic available in Zeropark. Domain traffic comes from users entering unused, parked domain names in the address bar of a browser. Such users are redirected to your full screen ad, either a landing page or an offer. Pop traffic. This traffic comes from opt-in adware. A user installs a toolbar in their browser and gives consent to allow pop-ups. They appear as a new window on top of the currently viewed tab or in the background. Pop traffic tends to have very high volume, so it requires quick and fast optimization. Push traffic. Push ads are delivered directly to users' desktop or mobile devices in the form of a push notification. They link to your landing page or straight to the offer. Push ads recipients receive these notifications even when they aren't browsing. It's a very flexible type of traffic. It is good for various kinds of verticals, as you can set your own image and text, pre-filtering the users unmotivated to click on your related offer. Since push operates on the CPC basis, you will only pay when a recipient is interested in your offer. Once you have selected the type of traffic, you will need to choose the campaign type. There are four basic campaign types to run on Zeropark. RON. This stands for Run of Network. If you select this option, you will target all available traffic from one specific geo, ignoring URLs and keywords. This is great for when you need high volumes of traffic and quick conversions. Run of Network campaign is recommended for testing. Keyword. A keyword campaign allows you to target traffic by related keywords such as hotels, booking, holidays, or specific URLs. If your offer needs a specific audience, this is the campaign for you. Multi-geo. With multi-geo option, you'll be able to target multiple countries in the same campaign. Within a multi-geo campaign, you will be presented with two further options. RON or keyword, which work in the same way previously mentioned. Target, source. These are whitelist campaigns, possibly the most effective kind of campaigns. You need to first know which sources, targets to add to your whitelist. Typically, you can do it in two ways. First one is running RON campaign and choosing the sources or targets that brought you the best performance. The other way is to ask Zeropark support team for a whitelist based on the performance in our platform. The target source category has two campaign types. Target campaign. A target campaign is the most accurate way to buy traffic, as the sub ID or target allows you to target one URL from a specific source. The difference between this and a keyword campaign is that a keyword campaign provides one URL from many sources. A source campaign allows you to target all sub IDs from a specific source. If you have a RON campaign and find that some of the sources perform better than others, you can start a source campaign to target the most effective sources. It's time to take you through a basic setup to get you started with your first campaign. We will use a pop campaign for this tutorial, as it has the simplest setup. Name your campaign. It is best to name it the same way you do in your tracker. The pricing model. If you have access to the smart eCPA feature, here you can choose between this or the CPV cost model. The smart eCPA feature requires you to use tracking and send the conversion data back to Zeropark. Campaign is optimized by our AI based on the target eCPA. This requires a testing budget to spend on the training period. After the model parameters are satisfied, no action is required. Once Smart eCPA is selected, you can specify the testing budget type. Each one is described below. For this campaign, I will go with CPV option, in which you pay for each impression. Zeropark offers you different inventory types you can select for your campaign. They differ by price and conversion rates. If you pick pop traffic, you will be able to choose inventory type: pre-selected, premium, standard, and remnant. This relates to the quality of the traffic, with premium meaning you are buying from only the highest quality sources. pre-selected, on the other hand, gives you the traffic that converts best at the moment. Now, select the campaign's target country. Then you can pick regions or cities. Remember that once a campaign is created, it's impossible to change countries, cities, or regions. You don't have to select any cities or regions if you want to target the entire country. Let's concentrate on the bids and the budget of the campaign. Input how much you want to pay for a visitor. To get a good idea of values you should be putting in here, please check out free traffic calculator tool available at zeropark.com/traffic-calculator. We will also talk more about this tool at the end of the video. Now, you can choose between unlimited daily spend or set a limit. You can do the same for the whole campaign budget. Remember that if you are testing, it's recommended to spend more to gather more information. You can choose a buying model. You can choose to spend your budget smoothly or buy all available traffic. Setting up a limit for the daily target and source budget will allow your traffic to be spent evenly among placements. Now we can move on to the targeting options. Targeting allows you to optimize your campaign. Let's go over particular targeting settings. Traffic filters. For starters, there are three basic targeting options. Desktop and mobile, targeting all traffic. Desktop only, all desktop traffic. Mobile only, all mobile traffic. If you click to expand the advanced targeting section, you can find more options. To select these, leave the box checked next to the ones you want. Here, you can select desired desktop, OS versions, and browsers, as well as mobile OS versions, and for mobile, the kinds of internet connection. Use the sliders to limit the OS version to the ones applicable to your offer. For example, you can select your campaign to be displayed only on iOS 10 or newer, or only on iOS 10 and 11. For mobile only, there's also an option here to choose specific careers. Click the checkbox next to the careers you want to receive traffic from. Frequency filters. This setting lets you determine how often you want to show your offer to the same visitor. You can choose to completely turn off the filter and have no restraints in displaying your ads, or make sure that the same visitor won't see it again until a certain number of hours pass. The higher the frequency of your ads, the more impressions you will buy. Adult filtering. Here you can decide if you want traffic from adult web pages or mainstream web pages, or both, if you're promoting a mainstream offer. Dayparting. This allows you to set your campaign to run at specific hours. If you have a campaign that only works during office hours, you just need to deselect the relevant boxes. After that, it's time to enter your destination URL, the address where you would like to send the traffic. Remember that Zeropark no longer accepts campaigns set on HTTP links. Don't forget to track your conversions. Tracking is the key to a positive ROI. Using the correct setup and tokens can give your campaign a huge advantage, as it will be much easier to optimize and manage. If you're looking for a tracking solution, we recommend Volume, which is the most comprehensive tracker on the market. Additionally, you can easily integrate Zeropark with Volume to enjoy additional benefits. Volume also offers a 14-day free trial for Zeropark users. In the last section of the campaign form, you need to specify what type of offer you are promoting, so it's easier for the compliance team to identify your campaign. Then, add the information about whether you use a pre-lender. Select what your campaign status will be once it gets approved by our compliance team. Now, click Save and the campaign will go to the approval team. And that's all when it comes to the campaign setup. Once a campaign in Zeropark is approved, you can activate it if you choose the pause status in the setup, and the traffic will start running. The next page will give you a summary of your settings, so you can check what you have set up. If you don't know how big your bid should be, remember that we have a tool for that. Zeropark.com/traffic-calculator. As your share of traffic and traffic quality is determined by how much you bid, it is very useful to have something to help you set a starting bid. Zeropark Traffic Calculator will help you judge the cost of the traffic you're targeting. It allows you to check average bids and available impressions per given campaign setup. you can calculate the traffic volume and the bit based on variables like
ad format, device, OS, geo, carrier, keyword, source.
These numbers are based on historical data from the last 30 days on the platform, so the cost may be a little higher than stated in the estimator, but it is a good starting point. Now, log into your account and make your first step towards making money with Zeropark. If you want to learn more, watch our next video in which we talk about optimization rules and how to set them up to make your campaigns perform better.